Guys, OVW here and welcome.
Hey everybody, OVW here. Welcome to this video. So we're going to do a crackle butterfly cup. And so here's everything you'll need. You need paint brushes, the tumbler, of course. This is a 20 ounce tumbler. The crackle medium, white paint, acrylic paint, and spray paint. And for the rest of it, you will need black vinyl for the butterflies and alcohol markers. So let's get started. So this is a crackle butterfly cup. So I did this cup before. I'll show you a picture. So the customer wants one just like that one. Okay, so I'm gonna do a little bit of movie play here. So here's the spray paint that I use. I use Rust-Oleum, and this is the color Rustic Orange. There you go. So yep, the cup is spray painted. So that's the first part, is spray painting the cup, okay? And then we're gonna do the crackle effect, okay? So stay tuned for the next clip. All right, so let's get started. I have Folk Art Crackle Medium here with my cup, and I have it on a stand so I can let it sit to dry, because I gotta do the whole cup. This is not a perfect spray paint job, you guys. As you can see, there's little wrinkles and stuff, but this is all gonna be covered, so it doesn't matter. Right, because I'm gonna go over it with white, so when it crackles, you'll see the orange coming through. Okay, so I just want to shake this up really good. Once again, this is Folk Art Crackle Medium. So I'm gonna pour some in this little cup. All right, so now I'm going to paint on the crackle medium, and I'm gonna try to just do long strokes. You're not really supposed to go over it a second time, so I gotta make sure when I put it on real nice and good, okay? So let's go ahead and put it on. Starting at the bottom and working my way, going all the way around. Make sure it's a nice coat on here, trying not to go over it a second time. Okay. Make sure you're getting them grooves. And we don't want to forget the bottom here. That got a crackle too. Okay, go over it one lightly time, going all the way. Okay, I think that's good. Going all the way around one last time. All right, and so I covered the whole cup, so I'm just gonna let this dry. All right, welcome back. We are ready for the next step. So I have my crackle medium on there, and it is dry to the touch. So now what we're going to do is pour a little bit of white acrylic paint. And I'm gonna squeeze just a little bit up in here, because now we're gonna paint the cup, okay? All right, so I gotta go the same way, same motion. I can't go over it twice because it's gonna start to crackle probably as soon as it starts to dry. So let's see, hopefully this is not a fail. So I got my flat end brush here, and I'm just going to go and paint like this. Just paint it on, and we're gonna see when it dries how it looks. Just gotta make sure I get a good enough layer of paint on here. And just paint it on As you can see, it's already starting to do the crackle effect. So you gotta be pretty quick with it. Pretty quick with it. Gotta be pretty quick with it. You see it crackling? Can you guys see it? You gotta be quick with it. And that's okay. So that's okay if you don't get it all. That's the rustic look of it, you know? It's okay if a little bit of orange show through. Look at that. You see it's crackling? Or cracking, I put too much. It's okay, the epoxy will cover that up. But can you see it there? The crackle effect? I really like. It crackled really nicely. Some spots better than others, but you know what? That's fine. Even the bottom did a little bit of crackling. So that's good. Like I said, you didn't have to have the perfect, the perfect spray paint job, because it just kind of crackled. And that's the uniqueness of it. So all I'm going to do is let this set. And then I will put on the first, I got a little boo-boo right there, but that's okay, because I'm going to make sure a butterfly go right in that area. Yeah, we're going to put butterflies on this. And it's going to be cute. So, yeah. So there is the crackle effect. So I'm going to let this dry. And the next clip, you'll see me epoxying it. All right, welcome back. So we're going to do the epoxy method, doing the glitter. So I got a piece of paper, so the excess epoxy will hit the paper. And then I'll put another sheet of paper under there when I'll then sprinkle on the glitter. So I have the epoxy all warmed up. Let me get another glove, which is right underneath you guys. All right. I got my phone on a tripod. I didn't feel like taking my camera down off the overhead tripod, so I'm using my phone. So hopefully this is pretty good quality lighting, okay? So this is not the perfect paint job, but it doesn't matter because glitter is gonna cover it. So I'm gonna cut the toner on. And I got my epoxy mixed in right here. So we're just gonna go ahead and pour it on. Just gonna go over it, and it can get messy. So that's why you got the gloves. You wanna get it all over the cup. And I never really measure epoxy. I have little pumpers on my resin. So usually one pump of A and one pump of B is more than enough to do one or two cups if I'm doing the glitter epoxy method. Make sure I get the bottom. Remember, when you're working with epoxy, make sure you're in a well-ventilated area, okay? And make sure you're not allergic to it. Well, you really don't know you're allergic to it until you start working with it. But yeah, if you get, oh, I got a little piece of something on there. Get that off. So just gonna make sure it has a nice coat of epoxy on here. And I'm gonna go over it with the heat gun to get all the little bubbles out. Although I really don't have to get the bubbles out because, like I said, it's just gonna be glitter covering this. So it's no big deal. But I'm gonna pop the bubbles anyway. Okay, now I'm just gonna get some of the excess off. So you get on that edge real good. Make sure I get the bottom real good. All right. So
now I'm going to set my epoxy to the side. Take my glove off, at least one of them. Get my torch here and pop some of these bubbles. This also gets the epoxy to really like thin out a little bit and get all the major bubbles, which it really doesn't matter if you're gonna put glitter on top of this. Really doesn't matter. Oh, did I just run out of butane and something? The bottom. Okay, so we're just gonna let that spin for a moment, and I'm gonna change my gloves or take my gloves off because I really don't need them anymore. All right, so I did spill a little bit of epoxy on this paper, so I'm gonna take this paper off and kind of get some of that excess off. Throw it away. Okay, now I'm gonna come in. This is what's gonna catch my extra glitter. That way I could put it back in the container. Okay, so I'm just gonna put that there and have my glitter here. And now I am just going to sprinkle all over. Look at that color. Look at that color, y'all. Isn't that pretty? It's so pretty. Ooh, so pretty. And I'm just gonna cover the whole cup. The whole cup. Make sure I get the top real good. Pull this paper down just a tad bit. Ooh, look at that. Instant pretty, right? Make sure I cover it all. Make sure I can't see the white of the cup underneath. And if I waste a little glitter, it's okay. It's okay. But it's so pretty. All right, and then I got to address the bottom, so I'm gonna pull the paper back a little bit more and just kind of dump it like this till I can get it all on the bottom. Get the bottom covered real good. All right, looks good. Sprinkle a little bit more just in case I miss some spots. It looks good, looks good. And this is just the basic way to glitter a cup, the epoxy method. What I do is once I get it on, I go over it with my glove finger and just kind of pat it in. Make sure I get at the rim real good. As you can see, it will get on my hand. And I just kind of pat it down for any of the glitters that is trying to like poke up. And I just kind of go over it. That's it. Yeah, I know, sorry. That's pretty much it. I'm probably gonna go over it a little bit more because I see a lot of wet spots. As you can see, it gets on my hand. Isn't that pretty on the black? Look at that color on the black. Oh, I'm gonna have to do a black cup with this. Look at that on my finger, the black. That is so pretty. It's like a gold almost. I'm gonna have to glitter a black cup and see how that turns out. Stay tuned for that, you guys. So yeah, I just kind of go over it like that and kind of pat it down. I'll probably put a little bit more glitter on it. I don't know. Let's see. But pretty much, that's it. And I will definitely record the next part, which is adding the butterflies and doing the coloring, which is my favorite part. So you guys are getting two videos back to back of butterfly cups, you guys. These were... Gotta get that bottom. These were customer orders, y'all. Look at this glitter on my black glove. Oh, It's just like gold. I'm going to have to glitter a black cup.
Welcome, welcome back. Okay, so this is all fully dry, so I'm going to put on a first coat of epoxy on that one. And I'm going to put the last epoxy on here. And then what I have left, I am going to be filling, doing this mold one more time. But this time, I'm going to do it in two layers. So the first layer, I'm going to do in this sangria color, and then the second, and then I'll put the lights in it while the epoxy is like almost set, and then I'll put a black glitter on the back, so it'll be black on the back but red in the front, so a two-tone. So let me get my gloves on to start this coat of epoxy. So I'm gonna do this one first. That way, when I do this one, if glitter gets in the epoxy, it's okay because that one's done yet. I am going to add a little bit of sparkle to the epoxy, but that's when I'm finished with everything. That's when I'm going to add a little bit of sparkle to it. So I have everything all ready to go here. So we're going to start with our first layer on here. Get it all on there nice and good. And I'm hoping that it is dry, which I think it is. Yeah, it looks like it is. Okay, nice good coat. Get the bottom real good. Cat's coming in here. Get out. I don't know if this is dry all the way. But we gonna make it work. We gonna make it work. We gonna make it work. All right. I'm gonna just let that spin. All right, so now let's go with here. This is just like a flood coat. The seal and the glitter. And then I can do my vinyl and my coloring on it. Bottom real good. See how there's glitter on my hands? I mean, if I wanted to go over that orange cup, I could, because I'm going to be putting glitter in the last coat of epoxy anyway. But yeah. And I'm going to use what's left for the love mode. I just want this just smooth enough to where the vinyl will stick with no problem. I think that's a smooth enough coat. Go over this. Like I said, it's okay if a little glitter gets on this. It's okay. I just want to make sure I got it all nicely covered. All right, I think we're good to go on both cups. All right, so now I'm just gonna change gloves for a moment. Let me get me a wet wipe out.
change gloves real quick. All right. So now we're going to do red glitter. Red glitter in here. Hopefully you guys can see. Let's see. Can you guys see? All right. So now you guys can see. All right. So I got the love. Got a little epoxy on this. All right. So got the mold here. I poured in my red glitter. As you can see here. Mix it up really, really good. Nice, nice, nice. All right, so now I'm just gonna pour it in. Hopefully, this is enough to go a nice thin layer. Oops. Actually, this is a really thick layer. All right. So I'm gonna just clean my mess up. All right, so the first layer is done. Hopefully it's even. Let's see. Got a little bit left here. So I'm just gonna let this set for a little while, probably a couple of hours. And then while it's still a little, you know, tacky, I'm gonna push in the lights. That way I know that it will stay. So we won't have that same mistake as I did before. And then I'll come in once that finally sets, then I'll come in with the black. So we're gonna see how it turns out. Let me see. I do want to make sure I get all in the corners. Let me make sure it gets all in the corners really good. Course, go up my torch to pop out any bubbles. All right, so we're gonna let that get tacky and then we'll do the second layer. So pretty much these two cups are halfway done. Once they set, I put the butterflies on it, the customization of the name on there. I'll color it, and then I'll seal it, and then it'll be the last coat of epoxy. So, yep, can't wait till it's done. See you in the next clip. Hey, everybody, welcome back. So I got everything I need to do the second to the last parts of this cup. I already put one butterfly on.
Okay, and so now what I'm going to do, they want faith, hope, and love, and then their actual name, which I have not weeded out yet, but the name is here. So I'm just trying to find out where I want to put faith, hope, and love. All right, so I got it on there. Sorry, y'all. I had to change my little SD card. I have the faith, hope, and love on there. So now what we got to do is put the name on there. And I already have the name already weeded out. So hopefully we don't have no issues. Because you guys, I have cut this out quite a few times already. Okay, let me make sure I got it in the middle. So about right here. So all right, now time for a few butterflies. So all right, so I got everything on there. The faith, hope, and love, the butterflies, and the name Sylvia. So now I'm going to put on my little watermark here, which says OVW, and I'm just gonna put it right here. All right, and take that off. There, and it is. All right, so now the fun parts begin, and that's the coloring part. So I still got vinyl all stuck to my hands. So I use Cali Art markers, and I got some from Tuesday Morning as well. This is a pack of 12 for $9.99. So I got two of them. So here's all the markers I'll be using. I won't use all of them, but I'm just going to do different type of, you know, colors. So for this orange one, predominantly they are going to be just orange and black, or like a dark orange and a light orange. So let's see, I think it's these two colors I used, and maybe a little bit of yellow. So, and I used the fine points. So these have dual points. There's a fine point and then there's a broad point there. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started with my coloring.
So I am done with this cup. So what I would do is pretty much seal it with a clear coat of spray paint. And that is just to seal the alcohol ink on there. So let me give you guys a, let me zoom you down. Let me give you guys a full turn of the cup. So faith, hope, and love. And then the butterflies. Isn't this pretty? It's so, so pretty. And then the last one at the bottom. So I will go put that to the side. And I'm going to spray both of the cups at the same time with the clear spray paint. So I'm not going to bore you guys with watching me do this cup. So I'll probably either do a time-lapse video or fast-forward it a little bit. And come back when it's actually done. But here it is before. Alrighty, I am complete with this cup. So she wanted the name in orange and yellow. I'm loving that orange and yellow ombre. Here's all the butterflies. Give you guys a, if it'll focus. There you guys go, the butterflies. Different colors. Tried to do a variety. There you go. And then I did the one at the bottom, as you guys can see here. So the next step is to give these a spray seal. And like I said, I'm just going to go over it with a very light coat of clear spray paint just to seal the alcohol inks. And then it will be ready for its final coat of epoxy. So I'm not going to bore you guys with the whole epoxy method. You guys already seen me put epoxy on a cup before. So there you have it. Two cups in one. Two butterfly cups in one. One is a crackle finish and the other one is just a glitter. All right, you guys. So thanks for watching.